Andrew Chuete.
Mr. Speaker, I thank you for giving me the opportunity to speak to the motion that this Honorable House approves the budget statement and economic policy of the government for the year ending 31st December 2022. Right Honorable Speaker, before I begin my debate, around the water sector, sanitation, sea defense, drainage, if time permits me, and probably housing as well. Let me take this opportunity to find out whether the Vice President, Dr. Mahmoud Bawumia, has been sleeping since 2017. If he's been sleeping, I call on the media to wake him up, to let him know that he's been in government for 5 years. Why am I calling for the media to wake Bawumia up? Mr. Speaker, before Bawumia became the Vice President, he told Ghanaians that 2 years into the MPP government, every village in Ghana will have a toilet. Every village in Ghana will have potable water.
He said it.
Dr. Bawumia, you are 5 years into government.
Yes.
We still have villages that do not have toilets.
Yes.
We have even cities that do not have water running through
yes.
their taps.
Yes.
And so the media must wake Bawumia up
yes.
and let him know that he is leading a team that has failed Ghanaians woefully.
Yeah.
And let Bawumia also know that this year's budget should be labeled anti-Bawumia budget.
Yeah.
Why am I saying so? Akufo-Addo and the Minister for Finance have deliberately refused to give Ghanaians water as directed by the Vice President. Akufo-Addo and Ken Oforiatta have deliberately taxed Ghanaians. They have asked us to pay e-levy, which Dr. Bawumia kicked against strongly. And so that is why I'm thinking that this budget is anti-Bawumia.
Yeah.
Mr. Speaker, to talk briefly on the water sector, this government is not a serious government. 5 years in office, they cannot tell Ghanaians that this is their policy direction as far as delivery of water to Ghanaians is concerned. What is their policy direction?
Yeah.
2 weeks ago, your committee, Western Housing Committee, we went to a meeting to look at the policy for water in Ghana. Mr. Speaker, the meeting failed. Even the ministers in charge of that sector, the deputy minister just came in and opened the ceremony and left. This shows that the government is not serious. Mr. Speaker, once again, I will say this government is not serious because this year's budget, the allocation that they made for the water sector, water and sanitation, Mr. Speaker, donors are providing 88.40% of the budget. Is this a serious country? You rely on donors for water supply and sanitation, so that donors should give 88% of your budget. Well, Mr. Speaker, we are all in this country, and like that musician said, Kroma Eshi, and we are all in it. No matter how Ghana is boiling, whether you are NDC or MPP, we are also in Ghana. And Mr. Speaker, what I want to say again in the water sector is that Ghana has a lot of water resources, so I don't see why we should be struggling to deliver water to our people. But you see, when you have leaders that are not serious, this is what happens. Before NDC left office, Mr. Speaker, we delivered over 1,000 boreholes to the people of Ghana.
Yeah.
This government in 2020, Mr. Speaker, 2020 budget, paragraph 800 of the 2021 budget. Mr. Kenneth Raita, when he came to deliver the statement, he told us that they were going to deliver 622 boreholes. I mean, 654 boreholes. And that out of the 654 boreholes, they were going to get 622 fitted with hand pumps. Mr. Speaker, 2022 budget, the same statement is repeated.
Hey.
Mr. Speaker, what is baffling so much is that in the 2021 budget, they indicated they had already delivered 535 boreholes. 2022 budget, they said they have delivered 533 boreholes. Which of them should we believe? Mr. Speaker, I'm tempted to start labeling some of the paragraphs as scam alert.
Yeah.
And for me, if you all agree with me, this whole budget statement, we can print boldly on it and let Ghanaians know that it is a scam. And so scam alert, that should be the title for this. Or better still, 419 budget. Mr. Speaker, Ghanaians deserve better. The group of people that are leading the country now, they came into office lying to the people of Ghana that they could do better. They came to office telling people that they could perform better than John Dramani Mahama and his team. Today, they have led the team, and even the leader of the economy team, who has now become a pious pastor, Reverend Dr. Mahmoud Bamia, the church elder, he looks straight into the eyes of congregants and tell them that they are delivering to the people of Ghana. Yet you go out and it's only difficulty. Mr. Speaker, the President, President Akufo-Addo, told Ghanaians that he was going to make Accra the cleanest city in Africa. Mr. Speaker, take a stroll to town and you see some of the portions, some of the areas of Accra, and you regret for paying your taxes. Mr. Speaker, sanitation tax. My people in Solatona Kalba constituency, the people of Soma, the people of Beneiri, the people of Kalba, who do not contribute to the filth in Accra, are forced to pay taxes.
Yeah.
Let me sound a word of caution to the minister, Honorable Abna, Honorable Cecilia Dapa, that when she is coming before the committee, she should be prepared to let us know where every CD they collected went to. We must let the people who paid these taxes get to know. Let me shout, Ayeshi. So I have to let people know that Kroma Ayeshi. Yes. We are suffering. Bamia had a song that the whole country we were all responding to. Ghanaians are suffering. Women are suffering. Children are suffering. We are suffering. Honorable Yabuama, we are suffering. And that is why I'm telling you. We are suffering. If you are not aware, if you are aware, we are suffering. Mr. Speaker, the challenges in Ghana are too enormous. This is a government that we can describe as the most insensitive government of our time. Why am I saying this, Mr. Speaker? Looking at the budget for 2022, before the Minister of Finance came to present the budget, we all heard the sad news in Volta region. The people of Keta, the people of Anglo. Mr. Speaker, the minister came to present a statement here without capturing anything about the sea defense wars in the Volta region.
Yes.
The Blekisu sea defense war, it was started in 2015 and completed in 2019. Mr. Speaker, when we went to visit the community to see the extent of work done at Blekisu, fortunately that day, Mr. Speaker, your committee was there with the minister in charge, Honorable Atachian. And Honorable Achatia, in his own words, told the people of Volta region that they were going to continue with the phase two as soon as possible. Mr. Speaker, we are in 2021, getting to 2022. It took the leader of the majority side to bring the minister to come and tell the people of Keta, when the phase two of the sea defense war will be started. Mr. Speaker, we are all surprised at the answer the minister came to give. This is what we describe as leadership that is not sensitive to the people that they serve. Mr. Speaker, the budget of 2022 never captured a single sea defense war. The budget of 2022 never talked about how they are going to protect the people who live around the coast. Even the projects that NDC started, that this government came to continue, they have not indicated that they're going to source funding for us to continue with those projects. It is sad. Mr. Speaker, let me say something briefly on drainage. Mr. Speaker, your own budget, this is a report that was submitted to this Honorable House, performance audit report of the Auditor General on the provision of flood control drains. The Speaker, it was submitted to this House in July of this year. This report laments so much about the performance of this government. The insensitivity that we are seeing now. The Speaker, government owes a lot of contractors. Government has not been able to pay contractors who work on drainage. The Speaker, government intentionally delayed payment of contractors. Go to town and see. You, those who have big drains around your constituency, go and see. They are all choked. 2021, we could not work on drains. 2022, we still have these challenges. And so, Mr. Speaker, sometimes when we hear our colleagues on this side hailing this budget, hailing the president, hailing the vice president, I wonder whether when they get back to their constituencies, they don't listen to their constituents.
Yes.
If you do listen to your constituents, you realize that this budget, like Honorable Doyo, my leader, said, it belongs to the dustbin.
Oh,
it doesn't belong here because it doesn't carry any good message to the people of Ghana.
Yeah.
Mr. Speaker, I'm not concluding yet. I want to talk about housing because you people came again, 2017-2018. I sat on the committee, Western Housing Committee. I moved with Honorable Atachian a lot. And Mr. Speaker, this government came, started commissioning projects that the NDC, led by President John Mahama, started.
Yes.
When they came, they were only commissioning. And at a point, yes, our own president was on salt-cutting spree.
Yes.
He was just going about cutting salt. Mr. Speaker, all the salt that the president cut, has he been able to commission one project?
No.
This is what we call insensitivity. Yes. Mr. Speaker, the housing sector faces a lot of challenges. Ghana, we have a housing deficit of over 2 million. And Mr. Speaker, the recent population census that was carried out tells us we have about 30.8 million people. And Mr. Speaker, the structures captured by the population census says we have over 10 million structures. And Mr. Speaker, out of these 10 million structures, about 20% of them are either wooden structure or metal structures. So it tells you that Ghanaians are in dire need of houses. And here's the case. We have houses that were built by a government. Then a government came and those houses are left to rot.
So
wicked.
This is wickedness.
Wickedness.
This is wickedness. And so, Mr. Speaker, Ghanaians are fed up with this government. Ghanaians do not know when 2024 will come. So they will throw Akufo-Addo and his Bamia out of the country. We can't continue to live under this government that do not care about the people that put them to power. All they care about is their own comfort. All they care about is traveling up and down. All the president cares about it is, look, and when you say this, it pains people. People get up and want to interact. It is a fact that our president pays so much on his travels. He should cut down those travels and build houses for Ghanaians to live.
Yeah.
Mr. Speaker, let me conclude by calling on all of us, to throw away this budget.
Yes.
All of us to throw away this budget because it doesn't carry anything good for the people of... Yes, Mr. Speaker, someone is shouting Sagaleme. Yes, we did something that we call Sagaleme. Beat your chest and tell Ghanaians what you also did.
Yeah.
We built something we call Sagaleme for people to live in. But because of your wickedness, but because you do not have concern for the people who put you there, Sagaleme housing project, beautiful edifice. Get there and see how they are. They are left to rot. And so if you are shouting Sagaleme, let me tell you, also go and build something and name it.
Yeah.
You came into power riding on lies. Now, the whole country, the whole world,
they have one more minute.
The kind of leadership that we have.
President, your pregnancy is exposed.
Mr. Speaker, that I should tell you that your pregnancy is exposed.
Yeah.
And so, Mr. Speaker, In conclusion, I call on the House, to reject this budget that does not carry anything, doesn't have any solution for the people of Ghana. I thank you, Mr. Speaker, for giving me this opportunity.